Good evening and welcome to Roongta Leadership Talk Series, a webinar on entrepreneurship for students by the Institutions Innovation Council of the Ministry of HRD, now Ministry of Education as per the National Education Policy. We are welcoming all the young boys and girls, the parents, the teachers, and all interested participants who are eagerly waiting for Mr. Shashikant Chaudhary to speak. We start sharp at 6 and we'll keep the timings as we've done for the previous series also with the guests. Their time is very important. So those of you who join late might be losing something, so join on time. The second thing is, in case you have some questions, you can pose them now. We'll take all those questions which are relevant during the conversation. इट इज अ फ्री विलिंग कॉन्वर्सेशन, यानी जो बात होती रहेगी उसमें अगला सवाल क्या होगा वो आपके ऊपर डिपेंड होगा कि वॉट आर द क्वेश्चन दैट यू वॉन्ट टू आस्क. सो इट्स अ वेरी इंटरेक्टिव सेशन, इट्स नॉट अ मोनोलॉग. सो ऑल ऑफ यू, आई रिक्वेस्ट यू टू पार्टिसिपेट, पुट इन योर आइडियाज, पुट इन योर क्वेश्चन, सो दैट वी गेट द मैक्सिमम आउट ऑफ मिस्टर शशिकांत चौधरी. And the aim of Roongta Leadership Talk Series is to bring in important stakeholders in the society. So we had a media person and management guru, N. Raghuraman, whose management funda you might be doing every, you might be reading every morning in Dainik Bhaskar. So he was here. Then we had Ambassador Deepak Vohra, again, a very versatile person who was an ambassador to Lithuania, South Sudan, and other countries of India, and was a voracious news reader and TV anchor in Doordarshan. We also had an ethical hacker who spoke to you in detail about the defense establishment and cyber warfare. Very interesting that day. We had a young boy who had not done his basic education, basic higher education, but still was doing enough that any engineer would have hoped to do and contributing to the country. We have in the same series, Mr. Anuj Sharma, the superstar of Chhattisgarh cinema. And in the same line now, we had media, entertainment, education, politics, bureaucracy, all those put together. Now we have someone from the domain of entrepreneurship, which is one of the majorly looked after or sought after areas of discussion for young boys and girls. Most of them want to get into the startup ecosystem, especially from the time when the 2014 government came into place, the awareness of Startup India, Digital India, etc. has been so large that all of us have been hooked on to all these terms like bootstrapping, startup, entrepreneurship, ecosystem, incubation centers, and so on. So today, most of these terms will be used. There will be some confusions, like what is a unicorn or some such confusions which most of you might be hearing but might be shy of asking. So I request you that we should delve in detail on all these aspects. So Mr. Shashikant Chaudhary is a serial entrepreneur. He is now an investor and mentor. He is funding and advising not only regular startups but student startups as well. He has invested in very interesting startups like Shepherds, MobiConTech.com, CarIQ, Location Guru, MedsOnWay, Genex Healthcare, eText, DonateCart, eFunnel.in, Concreto, Agile Connects, Wave, VideoCan, Weaver.ai, and few others. So he is a serial entrepreneur, a serial investor, and an angel investor again. So we have a lot to learn from him, because one, he is himself into startups, and the second is So you can learn how does he think when he gets an idea or somebody gets an idea and he gets involved in it. We can also look towards him for things like how to get funding because he's an investor. So he knows both sides of the thing. So good evening, Mr. Shashikant Chaudhary, and we welcome you to the Roongta Leadership Talk Series.
Good evening, Professor Jawar. And it's a pleasure to be over here. And thank you, inviting me for this Roongta Leadership Talk Series. And it's my privilege and honor. Glad to meet you.
Okay. Again, thanks to Roongta Group for hosting you. As Central India's biggest group, it is their responsibility to bring the student community together and put them in front of you. So that they gain from your knowledge and expertise. So let's start. So the new education policy, which is now after acceptance of cabinet, called the National Education Policy, lays stress on entrepreneurship in high schools as well as colleges. So from that perspective, what are the advantages of starting into entrepreneurship when you are in college? Is it too early?
Yeah, it's a nice question.
Okay.
You know, people have a lot of debates in terms of what's the right age for the entrepreneurship. To tell you, my experience and whatever I've read so far, and I've met so many people, there is no age for entrepreneurship. If a person is having that kind of an entrepreneurial mindset, he could be an entrepreneur. And basically, Indian society per se, we are entrepreneurial managers.
Sir, we can't hear you. Yeah. Sir, we can't hear you. Sir, we can't hear you. Some issue, some audio issue at your end, sir.
Is it okay? Okay. So, you know, we as a society are entrepreneurial by nature. We work in so much of constraints, Indian society per se. So each one of us is born entrepreneur in a way. The new education policy, which really facilitates lot of movement, you know, flexible kind of an education system now we have come in, where it's not like there is a defined path you have to go and you start from point A and you reach to only point B or point C. Now you can literally choose, you know, your choices. Whatever, you know, you feel that, okay, these are kind of things I should be learning. Even in the engineering, you can take the courses on the literature, you can take the courses on psychology. I mean, those are kind of the mechanisms which are being provided. I believe, you know, the best time to start, especially now, when we look at the Indian context, no doubt about it. I mean, college is one of the best times to start. Look at the kind of the things, you know, you don't have to pay rent because college would provide you facility. You don't have to pay electricity. You don't have to pay for internet charges. You get free access to your infrastructure. You get free access to the laboratories for testing your product. You get free access to the workshop for creating your products. At the same time, you know, getting the co-founders, believe me, getting the co-founders or working, getting the people to work for your startups, if you go outside, very talented people, you know, they will cost like a bomb, but these people are going to be available to work as a team, free of cost. You don't have to pay salary to these guys also. Even the professors are willing to help you, even your alumni. You know, and even generally the society, there is a soft corner for the people. If you say that I am doing a startup, I am being a student over here, and you know, if they see that there is a sincereness in your effort, I mean, they are ready to help you. You know, there are a lot of funds coming in from the pre-incubation grant, the funds coming from the incubation grant. There are multiple funding agencies. Money is not going to be a problem going forward because we have already moved from kind of a money-centric kind of entrepreneurship to an idea-centric, a knowledge-centric. So So knowledge is going to be the most important piece in the game. And if you bring in that kind of a knowledge and that kind of expertise, you know, you can definitely create a very, very interesting startup out of that. And, you know, it doesn't require an army of people to create some interesting companies. It doesn't take, if you look at one of the finest infrastructure being created in the world, which we know, it's the only country in India where you can transfer the, you know, money by just email addresses. Just by email addresses, you can transfer money from one account to another. Nowhere in the world such kind of system is there. It is one of the super highways, as they label it. How many people did it take to create this kind of system? Seven people. Seven people created the complete UPI infrastructure. It doesn't take an army. Look at Skype, look at Instagram, look at WhatsApp. These were not, these are all, you know, companies less than 50 people. I mean, it's not like that. And also look at it from the different angle. You know, all these bigger companies, if you take a look at those big companies, the genesis of those big companies were seeded at the college level. You take the Microsoft, Bill Gates, college dropout, Zuckerberg, college dropout. If you look at Apple, again, the college dropout. I mean, all these people who are, you know, who believe that they can change the world, these people really started out well when they were in the colleges. It's not that you have to, the good part is, there's too much of a knowledge. The people like us, like the people with the gray hair, that puts the boundaries to the imagination. We will tell you 10 reasons why it will not work. And most importantly for you guys and students, I mean, you are bold, you are imaginative, you know, you are courageous. I mean, you think of those ideas which possibly, you know, the older people cannot even think of, right? And young, we are going to be a young country. India is a young country where we have almost like youngest population in the world. The young people's problem has to be solved by young people. Old people cannot think the problem and they cannot empathize the way the problems are there for the young India. So therefore, young people have to come forward and, you know, solve and this problem. And the good part is the cost of technology has gone down. It has become very cheaper. I mean, it doesn't cost the same laptops which you use in the US, the same thing you use over here. The same processors you use over here. Same software which is released open source there, you have it here. The bandwidth, we have the cheapest bandwidth in India. You know, nowhere in the world we have the cheapest data bandwidth in the world. We are the cheapest. At present, we are consuming almost like, you know, 15 to 20 GB per month, an average user. We are consuming to that extent. So all the infrastructure is the same, right? It doesn't require a capital. It doesn't require license. It doesn't require people on the floor many times. I mean, even the distribution, creation of the product, you know, and distribution of the product, everything happens on the net. And therefore, it could be a global product also. I mean, if there is an appetite for the global product, that can be created in any part of the world or any corner of a, you know, society, in any four people sitting in any part of the college. If they think of a brilliant idea, you know, that's where your idea can become a very, very interesting idea. And that's what Dhirubhai Ambani said. Dhirubhai Ambani said that the big ideas, innovation, creativity, is not the only big companies do it. They can come in from anyone and any part. I mean, Dhirubhai Ambani, everybody knows, started from a petrol pump, and now these people are the fourth richest in the world.
So, fantastic opening here. One thing that comes out from what he said is that you are in probably the best times for the youth, especially in India. So we have a leadership that supports you. You have the internet that supports you, which he says is one of the cheapest. And you have the ecosystem that supports you. But my question is a question that most students put up. That, okay, we have an idea. We have a college that supports us. Like Roongta has a Ruby business incubation center in Roongta. So they support their students. Similarly, there are other ecosystems in colleges. But my parents say that you should get into a very fixed kind of a job and earn 35,000-40,000 rupees, which is better than having a startup. What do you say for this?
Yeah, I mean, you know, that's very interesting statement, always, you know, parents would be always worried about their kids, and they would be always protective, and their bias is going to be there, for their own kids. No, but you don't have to live parents' life. I mean, if there is only one life for you, you have to live your dreams, your life. I mean, no doubt about it. And at the end of the day, when you are starting inside the college, yeah, you have like from second year, you have got 3 years to play with. And with what is the, you know, what's the cost of failure there? I mean, you have an access, as you mentioned about it, incubation center, as well as this market is also there. Right, the market is also there. I mean, in terms of the student market itself in the Roongta institutions, you will have so many customers to test your product. So the customers are there. And you know, what would happen at the end of the day? Even if the second year you do some part of the business and that business fails, right? What is going to happen? I mean, it has been proved the cost of the failure is less, and the learning which you get by doing a real startup in the second year or third year is 30 times more than the formal education. So even if you fail, you will succeed. I'll tell you one example. And this is a true example, by the way. It's not something which I am making it up. There was this guy, Kunal Dhakne, from our college where I teach this entrepreneurship course. And this person was doing his entrepreneurship right from the second year. So he did first venture in the second year, didn't succeed, go. Then did another venture in the third year, and then still it did not go so far. And as the fourth year approached, their parents said, you need to get into the campus. And he said he is not really interested in getting into the campus. And he did not appear for most of the interviews, but at one point of time, he being a mechanical engineer, BPCL came in, and the interview was happening for a core sector. So for the core sector, this interview was happening. And this guy goes there, and out of the 30 minutes of the interview, the 20 minutes were only on what kind of entrepreneurial activity he did. Because he was different. He was not a Xerox. He was not a copy boy. He was not like every resume that was coming like a Xerox, and there was no differentiation. Here was a kind of a real life experience, and they really wanted to know what this person brought on the table. And this person got an offer of 16 lakhs in a core. Of course, he joined, but his mind was not there. In a year's time frame, he left the job, and he has joined Kunal Shah's company called as CRED, C-R-E-D. And he is almost working very close to his dream in terms of working with a CEO of one of the finest startups, which is now coming up, because Kunal Shah, it's his second company. So he's working with them. So you're learning whatever you get, you know, because see, this education, the college education, I'm not demeaning anything out of it. The college education is a formal education, will prepare for a career. Startup education, entrepreneurial kind of this kind of a practical education prepares for a life. So there is difference between preparation for career and preparation of life. You know, it has been proved that you are going to change, the young people are going to change at least 13 jobs in their career now. Every third year, they are going to get into a new kind of company, new kind of tech stack, new kind of demands. And it has been proved that almost whatever you are learning right now, you know, in the matter of 3 years, a lot of things would change, a lot of jobs would change, a lot of demands would change. The job will be reshaped, demands will be reshaped, the way of working would change. And now you are supposed to keep up the pace with this kind of a change throughout your life. You need to be preparing for the life. And you never know whatever you learn today in a formal way is going to help you or not in a major sense, because the next job which you are going to take might be completely a different stack, completely a different technology, completely a different way of working. So it's better rather than, I mean, you know, these experiences, what you get in the second year, third year, or you get the experience of fourth year, 3 years, I mean, cost of failure is less, and you are preparing for the life. What best? And the good part is, you know, you develop the entrepreneurial mindset. Succeeding in entrepreneurship or a startup is one output of it. But having worked on the startup develops your entrepreneurial mindset, which helps you to face any situations in your life better than any person who has not gone through it. You have gone through those cycles multiple number of times. And that's where you get prepared for the life. So even if you fail, you succeed. That's what I'm saying.
Okay. So very interesting. So let's again summarize what he said. That the risk of failure while you are at college and there is a whole support system in place, even if you risk failure, the learnings from the failure are so much valued that even they will help you not just in your future entrepreneurial ventures, but also if you do a job, you are prepared for life. The major associations like FICCI, CII, they say that only 25% of graduates are fit for employability. The basic reason is that you have not been experiencing life while you are at college. So you have a theoretical knowledge and you go and vomit that in your campus interviews. You might get selected, you might not. But there is a label that 75% of you are not fit. In case you take these risks at the risk of failure and learn something which makes you more better for life, Why not? What he says makes very good business sense, at least to me, that the outcomes of a college education, if you can add some experiences of life to that, nothing better than college education. And if you are able to get that in your 4 or 3 years, I think what he says makes sense to me now. Okay, sir. Sir, one issue again is... we don't have examples of people who have made startups in college and have succeeded within their college life. So can you cite some examples?
Why to get into college? Then you can go to up to school level also. So there is one guy called as Anup Deshmukh from Amravati. This guy is in 9th standard and he is paying an income tax and he's earning is 50 lakhs rupees a year. I mean, last year he paid the income tax on that in terms of like the company. So a great example of a person sitting out of a district called the Amaravati and still creating his startup company out of there. I mean, if you look at the other examples, let's look at some of those very interesting examples. One of my where I'm still teaching in BNIT, I teach this entrepreneurship course. There's a guy named called as Anil Kumar Reddy. So Anil Kumar Reddy was my student in the class, and you know, he was very passionate about the social side. So always used to work on the social kind of things and also interested in entrepreneurship. And once in the Chennai famous floods, he was there. He's from South and he saw the problem. And that sort of like at that point of time, he said, okay, he'll create a company out of that. And that company name is Donate Card. The people can type Donate Card. So Donate Card is a company which will help the donors to give their help to NGOs, but not in the form of money, because people worry that, you know, money can be misused, but in the form of products. So if an NGO wants 1,000 blankets, they will make sure that the NGO gets 1,000 blankets, not the money to buy 1,000 blankets. So that's a company he built in the college, and then he went on, you know, working on that. Can you imagine the last month, as we were into last month, The average donations that are happening through his site are 6 crores per month, I'm talking about. So if you look at, if you take it on an annualized basis, this will be almost like 72 crores to 100 crores. If you search his, you know, Donate Card on the Google right now, they have NDTV's partner. A lot of big people are talking about, you know, collaborating with the Donate Card and making sure the right help goes to the people in this calamity itself, which is the COVID calamity, what we have right now. Next example I would give is this company. the name of the company is still not well known, but this person has a very good passion. And he said that there is a gap in the market. There is a for a modular furniture, there are not many Indian brands. But a very sophisticated, very high-end furniture, let's take that as a space. I mean, everything is German, Italian, and all those things. And he said, why our company, you know, Indian cannot make those kind of brands? And this person refused the admission to Harvard. His name is Arjun Ashok. He refused that admission to Harvard, went on working on his product. And he created a beautiful kind of furniture piece, which is like an office cabin desk. But it is so beautifully designed. And it has so much of automation built in that, you know, you can literally talk to the table and table can go up and down and induction and all those biometric and everything stuff. He sells his one product, one table at 380,000 rupees. And three months back, he called me and said, sir, Prince of Dubai has bought my product. So now Prince of Dubai is his customer. And then, interestingly, what he said, because of there is a lot of automation which he has built and there's a lot of electronics also, the Apple India CEO invested 2 crores in his company. Not that, because of the electronics and all those things that goes into that complete piece. Now he said, you know, his product is getting into the health space. And what is that health space? Because, you know, the table knows what's my gait, how much time I'm sitting, you know, and the table would adjust and also would say to me as a user, oh, your gait is not proper, oh, you have sat for like 1 hour, you should get up and take a round. So it is being now promoted as a health conscious ergonomic product. And HP and IBM have given him a trial orders. And if that goes in well, you know, he would get almost like 500 pieces each from these two companies. I mean, these are young people. These are not like 38, 39, 50, 55. No, these are like 21, 22, 23. These are very, very young people. And if you look at, you know, some of those companies, one of the biggest unicorn, I mean, my youngest tech billionaire, I am saying, from India. Who were those people? Turakia Brothers, media.net guys, the youngest tech billionaires in the world. They started at the age of 18. And when they started at the age of 18, that means really speaking the first year of engineering college. That's the age we are talking about, by because 22 people graduate, 21, 22, but 18 is like a first year or second year. That time they started and created 7 companies in succession, and that these two brothers are the youngest tech billionaires. And the good part is, initially the technology was at the bottom. Then the technology started becoming a differentiator. And now the technology is at the top. And now the businesses are getting created inside the technology. And therefore, as this technology landscape is changing, lot many technologies are coming together, a lot of gaps are getting created and a lot of opportunities are getting created. In those opportunities, the businesses are getting created. Can you just imagine Uber without the technology? I mean, if our smartphones were not there, if our internet connectivity was very costly, which is in the world is 600 rupees per GB, and in India it is 18 rupees a GB. If the maps were not there, if the GPS was not there, the whole Uber business, whole Airbnb business was created because of the technology. So the complete business models are getting changed. And therefore, if you are from an engineering stream and all those things, you have an advantage, because all this new companies are getting created in the gaps of technology. And that's where the young people, for example, Shashwat is one of this person who started his blogs at the age of, I think he was in the 9th standard, Shashwat Shah. He was in 9th standard and he started his blog. And now there are 18 blogs, 9th standard. Now, of course, now he has graduated, but 18 blogs, and he earns just by blogs in multiple lakhs per month. I mean, this guy started in 9, you know, there were these two people who were brothers, and you know, they were supplying what they said, okay, let us supply the idli batter, idli banane ka jo ye hota hai, hum log usko supply karenge, but that should be fresh, there should be no additives. And they started this with only 50,000 rupees and it's only 500 square foot kind of thing. And now, you know, these people are doing 150 crores business, just a small business these guys are doing. For example, do you know, there is one guy, I mean, these are some examples from outside also, Kevin France. He was 15 years old when he developed the neural net for the face detection kind of system, right? I mean, the age is not the barrier. I believe age is your now advantage, because old people cannot learn these new technologies that faster. It takes time. Aapne dekha hoga, jahan bhi dekho, aap aapke ghar mein dekho, you know, all whenever the new gadget comes in, whenever the new TV, new recorder or new kind of phone and all those things, all these your uncles and papas are asking you to set it up. Arre, how should I do this? How? They are out of league now. They are out of league. And they cannot do it. This is, I mean, it's like the young people are taking over. Do you know the famous story of Reliance Jio? Reliance Jio ka famous story tha, Mukesh Ambani ki ladki, she was studying in Yale. Yale University, and she came back for the vacation over here, and she was, you know, doing her kind of a homework or whatever that was, coursework while being at India. And the internet connection, I mean, Ambani's can have the best of the, and they had best of the connection that time. And she said, this internet connection is not working properly. And Mukesh Bhai said, oh, this is one of the best internet connection we have. This was like, you know, before the Reliance Jio and all those things. And she said, oh, this is so bad. I mean, the internet is so much of a heart. And she was trying to explain why this is going to be the heart of the people and how this is going to be the next generation too. And that's what they were arguing about. And Mukesh Ambani was coming in from that direction. Oh, don't worry about it. Whenever we require any kind of thing, we will better call this person and we can discuss this person on the phone. And she said, no, Papa, that's not the case. We don't want face-to-face communication. We are fine communicating to the world without knowing them. We will type our request and we are happy when the request is answered. And that's where the discussion ended. And discussion said, that girl said to Papa, that is Mukesh Ambani, Papa, you don't simply get it. And that's where Mukesh Ambani realized, oh, you know, these young people think very, very differently. And that's the story of Reliance Jio that started coming.
Okay, so very interesting times again. So the younger you are, the better it is to be an entrepreneur. That is what the many examples that he has given are citing. To cut the long story short, the youth today think differently, and which is very, very right. There is one Sumit Foundation here. That guy was a policeman. His brother died in a accident, motorcycle accident. So that pushed him that maybe being a police, I have been doing whatever service I have been doing, but I am not doing enough. So the after the accident, the brother died of organ donation. So then this guy went into a research of what is ailing the organ donation, what are the laws and all that. And then he came up with a startup. He didn't have money. He was a basic policeman, not even educated. So he started a Facebook page. And then through the Facebook page, he gained sympathy and a lack of followers. And whenever there was an organ required or money required for treatment, the hospital would call him and say that this is the guy who requires money. He would go check the genuinity or send any of the 1 lakh people in that geography and check the validity. And then money, how it would come, each one of them would give 1 rupee. So 1 lakh rupees from the 1 lakh followers that he had. So it was not, it was crowdfunding any which way, but he started that way. Now he has an app, he is doing very well, the government support him, they ask him on what organ donation policy should be, and he started off as a policeman. So if there is a will, and if you have the passion to do that, I think what Mr. Shashi says, that resources are not are never an issue. So I completely agree, and I have seen many examples doing this. So we'll go ahead, sir. So one of the questions that the students have put up is that yes, everything like my background is very colorful when you talk to us. But in tier 2, tier 3 cities, we are not getting funding. This is what they say. So is it right that only the tier 1 cities get all the funding and these smaller cities don't get it?
Absolutely not. You know, the money will flow where the talent is. Talent is the most important. If your team is right, if your product idea is right, if you are executing it right, the money will follow the idea. It's not the other way around, that the privilege was with only people with the money. And therefore, you know, in the initial days, people also played cricket matches. In all the earlier days, all the cricket stars were from the Mumbai and Delhi and Bangalore and Calcutta and all those things. But see light right now, what's happening? All these Dhonis and RK Singhs of the world, these are, you know, coming from the cities which are far off. These are not like the main cities, and that's going to happen. We were 1,000 startups by 2010. We are 50,000 startups by 2020. We were zero unicorns. That means a billion-dollar company. In 2010, we are 30 unicorns right now, and more sunicorns. As they say, sunicorns means the people who are soon will become unicorns. There are many sunicorns in waiting. And believe me, the next 10 years, India is going to go to 150,000 startups easily. We are going to be the biggest startup and innovation hub. And that's where, you know, when your ideas are right and where your team is right, the money will follow. And see, to develop a proof of concept, to develop a smart product doesn't cost money too much. It doesn't cost money too much. Even you can put your idea on a Kickstarter, and that's a global platform. If your idea is good, if your design is good, I mean, the crowdfunding can happen through the world. I mean, it doesn't matter in which part of the city, whether you are from Mumbai or Nagpur or Jharsuguda or from New York. If the product is put on the Kickstarter, the product gets validated and you get funding also, and you can raise a lot of money. Even though there are a lot of, even in Raipur, I mean, when I came to Raipur a couple of times for some of the events, and I could see people over there who were ready to fund the startup ideas. I mean, the fund is never a problem. In fact, people are waiting for right people. You know, people are waiting for right people to start their companies and to fund the startups. The problem is on the reverse side. We sometimes think it takes too much of money. The example I said was like 50,000 rupees. Blocks jisne banaya tha, kitna paisa laga usko? Kuch bhi nahi. Tilak Mehta naam ka jo banda tha, the kind of the guy who did the tie up with the dabbe walas in Mumbai. 13-year-old, 13 saal ka bachcha tha, dabbe wale ke saath mein pura tie up kiya, and he created a courier service out of that. He gets 1,000 to 1,500 rupees per day. 13 saal ka ladka. Usko kya kitna paisa lagaya hoga usne? There is one more. You know, this guy, this is uska naam hai, bhi maine yahan pe likha hua hai. The name of that person is Akshay Mittal. Jab ye odd even formula laga tha, he created that application, and he created that odd even ke liye car pooling ka, and then he sold that company also. I mean, that company was acquired also by the company out of Gurgaon. Ayan Chawla naam ka ek ladka hai, 13 saal ka ladka, right? And this you know, people, when they started out their product companies, the amount which I am seeing over here is not even 10,000 rupees. Ye Ayan Chawla ne jab 13 saal ki umar mein company chalu kiya tha, 10,000 rupees mein chalu kiya tha usne company total. And then he started, went on starting 3 more companies and started with only 10,000 rupees in investment. It doesn't require too much of investment. Yeah, you know, to prove your concept, to prove your idea at a lower scale, you know, even if you prove that yes, if this particular startup idea can work, there will be a lot of people to follow. And initial level pay, all that funding you know, you can get it from your parents, you can get it not from the parents, if not, you can get it from the college. If your idea team is good, you can get it from the pre-incubation. There are a lot of schemes from MSME and Aspire and Incubation Center. People are ready to fund. I mean, that's not the case. I mean, and it doesn't require, that's what I'm trying to tell you, that is, yes, it requires a lot of money to scale. But initial level pe itna paisa lagta nahi har cheez ke liye. Many of those things can, I can tell you, many of those things, many of those technologies, because aapke paas overhead to kuch bhi nahi. Na aap rent de rahe hain, na aap salary de rahe hain, na aap electricity de rahe hain, na aap internet connected de rahe hain, aap air conditioning ka cost de rahe hain, na workshop ka de rahe hain, na R&D ka de rahe hain, na kisi ko jo advice kar rahe hain usko paisa de rahe hain, kuch bhi to nahi de rahe aap. तो आपका कॉस्ट कौन सा है? तो आपको तो रॉ मटेरियल चाहिए, कॉलेज भी दे देगा, इंटरनेट कनेक्टिविटी कॉलेज दे देगा, लैपटॉप चाहिए ऑफिस में, वर्कशॉप में बैठो, लैब में बैठो, वो भी कॉलेज दे देगा. तो खर्चा कहाँ पे है? अनलेस एंड अंटिल यू आर रियली क्रिएटिंग दैट लाइफ चेंजिंग टेक्नोलॉजी विच इज लाइक यू नो चेंजिंग टेस्ला इज कमिंग आउट ऑफ द न्यू कार एंड 5G न्यू काइंड ऑफ टेक्नोलॉजी विच इज कमिंग अप और यू नो एलन मस्क जैसा कुछ तो भी एक नया ला रहा है यू नो इन टर्म्स ऑफ द ट्रांसपोर्ट. Only these are like 2 or 3% which require huge initial capital investment. Yes, you require money, even you are in your normal businesses, but that money is typically required for scaling. Initial level pe itna paisa lagta hi nahi jab tak aap product ko prove karo.
So all of you might have got what he is saying. It's a matter of योर माइंड सेट कि आप सोचने लगते हो कि मुझे नहीं पैसा मिलेगा तो मैं फेल हो जाऊंगा तो दैट्स नॉट ए गुड स्टार्टिंग पॉइंट दैट्स व्हाट ही इज सेइंग. सर आई एम गोइंग स्लाइटली ऑफ ट्रैक बिकॉज नाउ वी आर टू मच इनटू एंटरप्रेन्योरशिप. कुछ अपने बारे में कि इन ए टिपिकल डे हाउ डू यू वर्क?
टिपिकल डे मेरा ऐसा होता है कि मैं मेरा जो एक एक्टिविटी होता है जहाँ पे मैं यंग लड़कों को एंटरप्रेन्योरशिप पढ़ाता हूँ, दैट्स माय पैशन. और वो एंटरप्रेन्योरशिप का कोर्स जो हमने स्टैनफोर्ड के मॉडल पे तैयार किया हुआ है और वो कोर्स मैं पढ़ाता हूँ इंजीनियरिंग कॉलेज में क्रेडिट कोर्स करके, सो इट इज़ अ पार्ट ऑफ देयर क्रेडिट प्रोग्राम. और उसमें कैसा है कि मैं अकेला पढ़ाता हूँ वो कोर्स शुरुआत में, तो मुझे सभी टॉपिक्स के ऊपर पढ़ाई करनी पड़ती, तो मुझे भी पढ़ना काफ़ी पड़ता है बिकॉज यू नो अपने यहाँ भी चेंजेस आते हैं और वो चेंजेस के हिसाब से जो रिलेवेंट केस स्टडीज है उसको लेके हम पढ़ाना पड़ता है, तो उसमें एक टाइम जाता है. तो मेरा दिन का जो एक डेढ़ घंटा पढ़ाई में जाता है, 2 घंटा मेरा सिखाने में जाता है. उसके बाद में मैं कुछ जो स्टार्टअप्स है, जो इंडिया के जो स्टार्टअप्स है, कुछ सिलेक्टेड स्टार्टअप्स को मैं मेंटरिंग करता हूँ. इसका मतलब है उनके साथ में एक एक घंटा मैं बिताता हूँ. तो मेरा जो एक आधा जो घंटा है दिन में, मैं एक या दो ही स्टार्टअप को मिलता हूँ तो उसमें 2 घंटे चले जाते हैं. और उसके बाद में ये जो आपका बाहर के स्टार्टअप्स की जो रिक्वेस्ट वगैरह आती हैं उसमें अपना जो टाइम जाता है, दैट इज वॉट मोस्ट ऑफ माई यू नो 8 to 10 hours वुड बी कंज्यूम्ड इन दैट.
तो सर आप फिर देयर इज यानी पिक्चर देखना, गाने सुनना, टीवी देखना, ऐसा कुछ नहीं होता है?
नहीं नहीं, सब होता है.
अच्छा. तो आपको कौन सा एक्टर एक्ट्रेस अच्छे लगते हैं?
एक्ट्रेस एक्टर में तो यू नो थोड़े हम लोग थोड़े पुराने जमाने के हो ही जाते हैं, तो उसका एक जो बायस है उसके साथ में आता ही है टोटल. वो बायस के साथ में जो हमारा जो टाइम था उसके टाइम पे जो सबसे बढ़िया जो एक्टिंग किया करते थे वो तो अमिताभ बच्चन ही थे तब के. और जो हीरोइंस जो सबसे अच्छी आती थी वो तो माधुरी दीक्षित. सो दिस वर द
टू ओके. जैसे आप वो यंग स्टार्टअप्स के साथ काम करते हैं है, तो यंग स्टार्स में कौन अच्छे लगते हैं आपको?
यंग स्टार्स में
हाँ
तो यंग स्टार्स में you know on the male side on the male side mujhe rajkumar acha lagta hai.
rajkumar rao
very offbeat karta hai but then he is very nice every film which I like. Baki star wale to kafi hai, there are lot.
Aur heroine
side mein to deepika
Oh, very good. चलिए बढ़िया. तो दीपिका एंड राजकुमार राव इज पसंद. वन ऑफ बीट एंड वन फुल्ली इन बीट. तो सर इसमें नाउ वील कंपेयर बैक अगेन टू स्टार्टअप. सो वन पर्सन राइट दिस एंड आई एम कोटिंग हिम. This is not my idea. 95% of startups fail in 3 years. Remaining 4% fail in next 5 years. Only less than 1% are successful. I have few questions. When success rate is so less, why should I go for it? Second, we talk of successful startups, but there is no support system for this failed 99% startup and people working in those. Please elaborate.
Correct. See. क्या होता है कि अगर हम कोई एरिया में जा रहे हैं तो इन दैट पर्टिकुलर स्पेस वी नीड टू यू नो फॉलो सर्टेन डिसिप्लिन राइट. और हम वी नीड टू क्रिएट अंडरस्टैंडिंग ऑफ दैट पर्टिकुलर स्पेस. नाउ व्हाट इज हैपनिंग मेनी टाइम्स पीपल गो अनप्रिपेयर्ड. यू नो इफ यू वॉन्ट टू गो फ्रॉम नागपुर टू रायपुर यू नो इफ देर इज अ रोड काइंड ऑफ डिस्टेंस यू विल एटलीस्ट नो हाउ मच डिस्टेंस इज देयर. You know, where is it going to be traffic? Where I should fill the petrol? How much time does it take? Where are the diversions I have to take? I mean, you have to know what this journey encompasses. What are the, you know, at least uska to pura malum hona chahiye. Number one. Number two, so people jump without, you know, really looking at the, you know, what my journey would ask me to do. The next thing is, you know, if you are under-resourced, right? अगर आपकी डिफिकल्टीज आ जाती है सो मेनी ऑफ द स्टार्टअप्स क्या हो जाता है कि बिल्कुल यू नो दे स्टार्ट विद समथिंग सम एजम्पशंस व्हिच आर आई एम यूजिंग अ वर्ड एजम्पशंस दे स्टार्ट विद दैट एजम्पशंस एंड देन व्हेन दे स्टार्ट वॉकिंग द जर्नी ओ दिस ऑल टुगेदर डिफरेंट मार्केट वॉज एक्सपेक्टिंग समथिंग वेरी वेरी डिफरेंट एंड टिपिकली बाय दैट टाइम योर टाइम इज लॉस्ट राइट योर फ्यूल इज लॉस्ट एंड यू कम इन टू द वैल्यू ऑफ डेथ. And the startup starts dying down. Now the point is, there is a systematic process around it. Not that it will guarantee you, but you know, a lot of this art of doing the business is now getting converted into a lot of science to it, because all these people are converting that back. And what does it mean? It means that don't start with the assumptions. Don't love your product so much. You know, प्यार में अंधे हो जाते हैं. So don't love your product so much. The customer has to like it. Don't build a product and ask customers to come. Find out the need of the customers. Find out the customers with large customers with a problem and then create a product. So that means what we have seen, the people who start with this kind of approach in terms of like assumptions, you know, we have found practically 65 to 70% of assumptions are invalid. I mean, you know, market is asking something else and you have produced something else. So market yahan pe is demanding and your product is not matching here, your product is somewhere here. I mean, that's going to fail. So that really means what needs to be done is, which is a phase. Hum log zara usko technical term use kar lenge, kuch bhi kar lenge. But that initial phase of, isko teen phases bolte hain. Pahli phase, उसको रिसर्च करना पड़ता है कि प्रॉब्लम सॉल्यूशन फिट बराबर है. दैट इज नंबर वन, प्रॉब्लम सॉल्यूशन फिट. दूसरी फेज आती है प्रोडक्ट मार्केट फिट और तीसरी फेज आती है बिजनेस मॉडल मार्केट फिट. ये तीन अलग अलग फेजेस हैं. ये पहली जो दो फेजेस हैं, ये पहली दो फेजेस जिसको बोलते हैं कि प्रॉब्लम सॉल्यूशन फिट एंड प्रोडक्ट मार्केट फिट. अब जरा थोड़ा सा आसान कर देते इसको. देखो प्रॉब्लम तो है, फॉर एग्जाम्पल द म्यूजिक इज अ प्रॉब्लम राइट. पीपल वॉन्ट टू लिसन टू द म्यूजिक बट बिकॉज द टेक्नोलॉजीज हैव चेंज द सॉल्यूशंस हैव चेंज. पहले हम लोग ग्रामाफोन पे पढ़ते थे, रेडियो पे सुनते थे, फिर टेप्स आ गए, फिर सीरीज आ गई, फिर डीवीडीज आ गई, फिर यू नो एसडी कार्ड आ गया, फिर फ्लैश ड्राइव्स आ गई, उसके बाद में फोन पे और उसके बाद में स्ट्रीमिंग म्यूजिक स्टोर भी मक्का. सो द सॉल्यूशंस हैव चेंज, प्रॉब्लम इज स्टिल द सेम. बट with respect to the current situation where we are, for the same problem the solution has to be different, and therefore first the problem has to be there, and for that problem this type of solution, whether aap agar baba adam zamane ka solution denge nahi bhai aap tape hi sunna padega aapko, to kaun लेगा आपका प्रोडक्ट कोई नहीं लेगा. सो दैट्स अ प्रॉब्लम सॉल्यूशन फिट. द सेकंड इज अ प्रोडक्ट मार्केट फिट, राइट. सो इन दैट फेज व्हाट यू जज कि व्हाट एग्जैक्टली बीइंग एक्सपेक्टेड एट व्हाट प्राइस पॉइंट, यू नो हाउ विल यू काइंड ऑफ यू नो दिस मार्केट एंड व्हाट काइंड ऑफ फीचर्स व्हाट market is expecting, are we really producing that particular product with the expectation of the customers. This journey is close to anywhere between 6 months to 18 months. Now people want instant dosa, instant gratification. Unko lagta hai ki stories news mein padhte hain, unko lagta hai ki 18 mahine mein 24 mahine mein to hum to company billion dollar ki bana denge. वैसा होता नहीं. आप जब न्यूज में जब सुनते हो तो वैसी स्टोरी सुनते हो जो थोड़ी सी इसोटेरिक होती है. एक तो कंप्लीट फेलियर सुनते हो या कंप्लीट बिलियनरी बन गया वो सुनते हो. बट इफ यू टेक दिस पाथ सिस्टमैटिकली द आइडिया इज इन दैट फर्स्ट 6 मंथ जो हमने बोला था कि प्रॉब्लम सॉल्यूशन फिट और प्रोडक्ट मार्केट फिट, ये लोएस्ट कॉस्ट में आपने करके देखना चाहिए. एक बार आपने वो करके देखा तो वो क्या होता है कि आपकी जो एजम्पशंस है वो फैक्ट्स में तब्दील हो जाती है. और जैसे आपको चांसेस ऑफ सक्सेस बढ़ जाते हैं. आर वी देयर? या सो आपकी जो चांसेस ऑफ सक्सेस, सो बेसिकली व्हाट इज द इन अ शॉर्ट व्हाट इज दैट वी आर सेइंग, डू दैट एक्सपेरिमेंटेशन फेज एट अ लोएस्ट कॉस्ट. Test your idea before spending too much of money and time. If you are going to be spending 8 years for a startup, it's always worthwhile to spend that first 3 to 6 months in doing that actual in-field market mein jaake test karo, banao, dikhao, aur wo chalta hai ki nahi, nahi chalta hai to uske hisab se changes karo. ये पूरी इटरेशंस फास्ट करते बैठो. जब आप वो स्टेज पे पहुंचे तब आप स्केल करो, कोई प्रॉब्लम नहीं. तो होता क्या है कि बिकॉज ऑफ नॉट अंडरस्टैंडिंग ऑफ द अप्रोच तो लोग गलत तरीके से, काफी जगह में मैंने देखा हुआ है कि सब ठीक है बट अप्रोच थोड़ी सी गलत हो जाती है तो पैसा खर्चा हो जाता है, मॉरल डाउन हो जाता है, टीम डिसइंटीग्रेट हो जाती है एंड देयरफॉर द सक्सेस रेट्स ऑफ द स्टार्टअप्स यू नो starts going down. Because अगर समझ लो मुझे नागपुर से रायपुर जाना है और मुझे you know I have to have a मुझे 125 लीटर का डीजल लगने वाला है 125 लीटर और आपने गाड़ी निकाला और 10 ही लीटर तेल डाला है, डीजल डाला है, तो फेल होना ही. I mean there is no question asked on that. What people do, नहीं मैं बनाऊंगा तो पूरे कस्टमर दौड़ते हुए मेरे पास आ जाएंगे, मैं बैठा रहूंगा और मेरा प्रोडक्ट वायरल हो जाएगा एंड पीपल विल जस्ट फ्लॉक. ऐसा होता नहीं. इट्स अ डिसिप्लिन जर्नी एंड इफ यू डोंट हैव दैट डिसिप्लिन माइंड देन द चांसेस ऑफ सक्सेस गो डाउन. अभी कैसा होता है, काफी लोग हाइप में कर डाल इसीलिए फेलियर जा रहा है.
वेरी गुड सर, ब्यूटीफुल. इसमें दो चीजें मैं जोड़ना चाहूंगा सर कि एक एग्जाम्पल है कि सिर्फ आप लोग नहीं हो जो फेल हो रहे हो, बड़े बड़े लोग जिनकी कहानी आप सुनते हो वो भी फेल हुए रहेंगे. उनकी वो फेलियर की कहानी इज मे बी नॉट विथ यू, दैट्स इट. सो यू ओनली सी देयर पार्ट ऑफ सक्सेस. मैं एक स्टेज शेयर कर रहा था किशोर बियानी और फ्यूचर ग्रुप यानी बिग बाजार जो चलाते हैं, तो उन्होंने बताया था ये चीज कि वो चाइना गए थे and there he was going around in China and he saw ki around 20 lakh shirts, 2 million shirts, white shirts वहाँ पे थे और वो मिल रहे थे उनको 40 रुपए में. वो बोले यार इंडिया में मैं 200 रुपए में बेच सकता हूँ ये shirts को. तो just the fact that the shirt was available for him at a very low cost, he purchased all of them और बोला मेरे stores का chain है उसमें मैं डाल दूँगा. Now what he says is, when he was seeing the daily report, the shirts were not moving at the rate at which he was thinking. देखिए, big bazaar is basically a middle class thing. जो आप देखते हैं कि white shirt daily पहनता है, वो या तो एक white collar employee होता है या फिर एक नेता होता है. तो जो middle class आता है, तो वो बहुत सी चीजें सोचता है कि ये shirt खरीदूंगा अगर 100 रुपए में. big bazaar was selling it at 200 rupees. कि 200 रुपए में इसका मेंटेनेंस कॉस्ट कितना आएगा, ये सोचता है एक मिडिल क्लास आदमी। हाँ, इसको मेंटेन करने में 200 रुपए आ जाएगा, तो दे वर नॉट बाइंग इट। ये 2000 की बात बता रहा हूं मैं। सो ही सेड द शर्ट्स वुडंट सेल एंड माय डिसीजन वाज जस्ट इन्फ्लुएंस्ड बाय द प्राइस एंड नॉट वेदर इट वाज फिट फॉर द इंडियन मार्केट और नॉट। दिस इज व्हाट मिस्टर शशि इज सेइंग। वन द सेकंड इज एक्चुअली द रिसर्च दैट वाज डन व्हिच इज एशियन स्काई शॉप जी का मैं एक हिस्सा रहा हूँ एंड एशियन स्काई शॉप विच वॉज द फर्स्ट सैटेलाइट मार्केट दैट वी क्रिएटेड देन अगेन दिस वॉज लॉन्ग बैक 1994। सो जब हम लोगों ने क्रिएट किया तो हम लोगों ने बैठ के, मैं बैचलर था उस टाइम, तो बैठ के यही काम कर रहे थे कि क्या तकलीफें आ रही है हमको, प्रॉब्लम क्या हो सकता है। तो हमको रोटी बनाना नहीं आता था गोल। हाँ, वी कुड मेक अ रोटी विच वॉज गोल। सो वी थॉट दैट प्रॉब्लम वॉज रिक्वायर्ड फॉर ऑल बैचलर्स हु वर कुकिंग फूड। सो वॉट वी सेड कि लेट अस ट्राई एंड मेक अ रोटी मेकर। सो रोटी मेकर वॉज मेड, यू जस्ट मेक अ गोल एंड पुट इट इन द रोटी मेकर एंड प्रेस इट, इट बिकम्स अ गोल रोटी। सो गुड फॉर अस। The first day we sold around a lakh of pieces on satellite TV. First day, day one. वहां से satellite TV में market शुरू हुआ था Asian Sky Shop से, Mr. Kurian was heading. So we did the research, we found that this is a market fit and then went into the market. So go to market जब हो गया तब भी हम गए और वहां बियानी साहब ने गलती कर दी कि उन्होंने ये सब चीजें की नहीं। So for you all, there are many failures that are there hiding behind the screen for even achievers, big people. Sir, boliye sir.
Do cheeze add karo. See, you know, aap galti se fail bhi ho gaye. Age bhi chalta hai.
Maan lete hain.
Mere pehle zindagi ke 4 saal nikal gaye. Main to 83 mein graduate hua, meri company jo thi wo puri dub gayi thi. By 87, you know, I was in the home doing nothing. I mean, everything was a failure. But, you know, initial stage mein, aap agar fail bhi ho gaye, to do cheeze main bataun. First, jitne bhi companies hain, inko abhi log aise chahiye jo entrepreneurial nature ke. Agar innovate karna hai, to unko employee aise chahiye. That is number one. Aur dusra, thoda sa mazakiya tone mein, thoda sa lighter tone mein. Pehle, aadmi log ud jate the 60 saal mein. अभी 80 साल में भी कोई नहीं उड़ रहा है। द रिसर्च हैज सेड इन द नेक्स्ट 25 इयर्स द फार्मास्यूटिकल रिसर्च विल इंक्रीज द लॉन्जेविटी टू 125, यू नो, इन द नेक्स्ट 25 इयर्स का जो बता रहा है। तो एवरेज आपकी लॉन्जेविटी 80-90 साल तो होने वाली है, राइट? आपके जिंदगी के 2 साल इधर भी उधर हो गए। मैं इसीलिए बोल रहा हूँ कि होना चाहिए, बट अगर रास्ता हो गए तो इन span these 2 years worth experience in your life.
Yes,
live your dream. You know, sabse bada aadmi ko dukh kaun sa hota hai? Sabse bada dukh ye hota hai, there was a battle to be played, that was a time when the battle to be played. Mujhe sirf gham isi baat ka hai, jeetu haru iska gham nahi hai, khela hi nahi iska gham zyada hai.
ये रिग्रेट बाद में होता है हम लोगों को। ये बिल्कुल सही कह रहे हैं कि मैंने वो नहीं किया था अपने टाइम पे। हाँ, ये चीजें सर, चूंकि आपने वो म्यूजिक की बात कही थी कि वो पहले ग्रामोफोन था, ये था, ये था, तो आपको कौन से गाने अच्छे लगते हैं सर?
मैं यू नो, मुझे जो ज्यादा म्यूजिक पसंद है, इट इज फ्रॉम 19 द गोल्डन एरा ऑफ इंडियन म्यूजिक, व्हिच इज 1957 टू 1969. इन दैट दिस वेर द वन ऑफ द बेस्ट म्यूजिक्स व्हिच इज लास्टिंग राइट नाउ आल्सो. इवन आई लिसन टू दो दैट काइंड ऑफ म्यूजिक एंड आई प्ले फ्लूट. सो आई प्ले फ्लूट एंड सो मोस्ट ऑफ द सॉन्ग्स आई प्ले फॉर किशोर कुमार.
अरे वाह सर, अभी उनका 91st बर्थडे हुआ था जस्ट नाउ, दो तीन दिन हुआ है उनका 91st बर्थडे हुआ है. लवली. सो सर, वन और टू लास्ट क्वेश्चन, वी डोंट हैव मच टाइम. वन सेज, आई फील समवन विल स्टील माय आइडिया, बट इन एनी प्रेजेंटेशन वी नीड टू प्रेजेंट आवर आइडियाज, व्हाट सेफगार्ड शुड बी टेकन? एंड ये जनरली लोग कहते हैं कि मेरा आइडिया चुरा लेगा सामने वाला.
एक बात बताता हूँ, बिंदास बताओ, कोई आइडिया चुराने वाला नहीं है. आइडिया चुरा के कुछ होता नहीं है. आप वो आइडिया से क्या गेम खेलते हो और वो गेम खेलने का आपका तरीका क्या है, ये डिसाइड करता है कि आप विनर हो कि लूजर हो. आइडिया, मोर देन द आइडिया, आई वुड से मोस्ट ऑफ द प्ले 95% ऑफ योर सक्सेस इज ऑल एग्जीक्यूशन एग्जीक्यूशन एग्जीक्यूशन. एक ही स्पेस में यू विल फाइंड ऑलमोस्ट लाइक 70 to 80 कंपनीज वर्किंग ऑन द सिमिलर आइडिया, यू विल फाइंड. बट एवरीबडी हु इज ट्राइंग टू प्ले दैट गेम विल प्ले दैट गेम डिफरेंटली. और ये एंटरप्रेन्योर्स की खासियत है, वो एक गेम को जैसा एक पूरा एक कड़ी समझ लो आप, जिसको हम वैल्यू चेन बोलेंगे, ये पूरी कड़ी को वो देखता है कि ये कड़ी का एक कंपोनेंट निकाल लो और उसको एक अलग ढंग से खेलो सो दैट माय अप्रोच बिकम्स अ वेरी डिफरेंट. एक एग्जांपल बता रहा हूँ, यू नो इतनी सारी मैजिक डॉट हाउसिंग डॉट कॉम, मैजिक ब्रिक डॉट कॉम, कॉमन फ्लोर डॉट कॉम, रियल इस्टेट के रेंटिंग काफी सारे साइट्स चल रही. नाउ दिस गाय केम इन कॉल्ड एज नो ब्रोकर, नो ब्रोकर डॉट कॉम, आपने अभी टीवी पे आप आइडिया दे ब्रोकर. उसने क्या बोला कि ये पूरी चेन है, ये पूरी चेन में एक कंपोनेंट में लेता हूँ, चलो एक कंपोनेंट लिया. ये कंपोनेंट कौन सा है कि जहाँ पे ब्रोकरेज लगता है, राइट? मैं कोई भी अगर चीज खरीदू या रेंट करूँ तो मुझे ब्रोकर को उसका एक महीने का रेंट देना पड़ता है, या मेरे को उसको जो सेल करूँ तो उसका मुझे परसेंटेज देना पड़ता है. उसने क्या किया, ये ब्रोकरेज को हटा दिया तो नो ब्रोकर हो गया. आप सेल करो या परचेस करो, ब्रोकरेज चार्ज लगेगा नहीं. और अपने साइड के लोगों को बोला कि मैं लगाने वाला नहीं हूं, बिल्कुल नहीं लगाया उसने. पूरा उसके ऊपर ट्रैफिक काफी आना चालू हो गया तो उसने ब्रोकरिंग चार्जेस नहीं लगाया. फिर बाद में जैसी कम्युनिटी उसकी बढ़ गई तो उसके बाद में बोला, हाँ अभी आपको रजिस्ट्रेशन करना है, आप नागपुर में बैठे हो, आपको प्रॉपर्टी सेल करना है मुंबई में, मैं ऐसी एक प्लेटफॉर्म बना, एक ऐसी सर्विस चालू कर रहा हूँ कि आप घर बैठे बैठे सेल डीड कर सकते हो, बट उसका चार्ज लगेगा. अच्छा, आपको इंटीरियर का कुछ काम करवाना है, अच्छा आपको घर शिफ्ट करना है, उसका ये भी हम करेंगे, ब्रोकरेज नहीं लेंगे, बट कम्युनिटी बनने के बाद में इसके जो सर्विसेज अभी ऑफर जो थी ये सर्विसेज को चार्जेबल कर दिया उसने. एंड ही इज क्रिएटिंग वन ऑफ द बेस्ट कंपनीज. आइडिया तो वही है, कोई नया गेम नहीं था, रेंट करना, सेल करना, परचेस करना प्रॉपर्टी का, वही आइडिया चल रहा है. और ऐसे कितने तो भी साइट्स है, लोकल साइट्स भी देखते हैं हम और नेशनल लेवल की भी साइट्स है. इसने गेम अलग ढंग से खेला. आइडिया का कोई मतलब नहीं है साहब, वो ओनली 3% आइडियाज ऐसी है कि जहां पे वर्ल्ड को आप चेंज कर सकते हो, पैराडाइम शिफ्टिंग जिसको बोलते हैं. बाकी 97% ऑफ द आइडियाज आर सेम. इवन द बिगेस्ट कंपनीज डू इट, यू नो AWS का क्लाउड देखो, Amazon का क्लाउड देखो, Microsoft का क्लाउड देखो, Dropbox का क्लाउड देखो, Apple का क्लाउड देखो, iCloud, क्या फर्क है इसमें? सभी तो सेम ही है, क्लाउड ही है, स्टोरेज ही है. हर एक जो आइडिया में कोई इशू नहीं है, आइडिया डजंट मेक यू विनर. हाउ यू एग्जीक्यूट दैट आइडिया विथ अ वेरी डिफरेंट मॉडल एंड डिफरेंट इनसाइट, दैट विल मेक यू सक्सेसफुल. डोंट वरी, सबको दिखाओ, कोई चिंता मत करो.
तो छुपा के रखते हैं करके 3 idiots में वो बोलता है, हाँ चतुर वो मत करना आइडिया के साथ, ये दिस व्हाट शशि जी इज सेइंग. दिस नो ब्रोकर अमित अग्रवाल इज फ्रॉम आईआईटी खड़गपुर. आई हैड अ चांस टू मीट हिम, वेरी सिंपल गाय, ही इज एन आईआईटी आईएम. बट सही बात है, अगर एक पैराडाइम उठा लिया है आइडिया का, इट डज नॉट मीन कि सभी लोग आप ही का आइडिया चुरा के काम कर रहे होंगे. गलत सोच रहे हो आप, या तो आपके आइडिया पे आपको कॉन्फिडेंस नहीं होता, ये भी हो सकता है कि आप उसको छुपा के रखने की बात कर रहे हैं. इट डजंट वर्क दैट वे. एनीवे सर, वन मोर, आई थिंक आई हैव अ गुड आइडिया बट एवरीबडी सेज इट विल नॉट वर्क, बट आई स्टिल थिंक इट विल वर्क, व्हाट शुड आई डू?
वेरी वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट, डोंट लेट अदर पीपल इन्फ्लुएंस यू. इफ यू बिलीव इन योर आइडिया, इट्स वर्थ टेकिंग दैट चांस. It's worth taking that chance. And the way you should take that chance is, as I said, that don't spend too much of money in terms of executing that idea. First, do it on a smaller level. Test it out. Do that experimentation on the ground with the people who are supposed to be using it, not in the lab. घर के बाहर निकलो, ऑफिस के बाहर निकलो, छोटे लेवल पे उसको टेस्ट करो, देखो इनसाइट्स क्या आ रही है, एंड मोमेंट एंड यू विल रियलाइज, अरे यू कैन एग्जीक्यूट दैट आइडिया इन अ वेरी डिफरेंट मैनर आल्सो, बट बिकॉज यू आर स्मॉल, यू आर निम्बल, यू कैन इटरेट, यू कैन चेंज द डायरेक्शन इन बिटवीन, एंड मे बी यू कैन क्रिएट अ वेरी स्मार्ट प्रोडक्ट. सो इट्स वर्थ टेकिंग अ चांस विदाउट स्पेंडिंग टू मच ऑफ मनी.
Lovely, sir. Great interacting with you. And I think this is a $1 million idea to interact with you for all the students who have taken advantage of his experience. We need to thank Santosh Roongta Group for providing this opportunity for them. The parents of students who are reluctant to put them into entrepreneurship mode, please give them that chance to prove themselves for 2-3 years, as Mr. Shashi has said, instead of saying no to everything that they want to do. So it works. It works a lot of times, and people regret why we said that at a later stage when the children are successful. So all in all, keep your mind open. Keep thinking the way you think. All you think, as Mr. Shashi said, they think better than us or different than us. We might be very conservative in our approach, but you all are not. But a word of caution is that yes, we are the youngest country today in the world. So even if 65% is youth, please remember that in 20 years, we might be the oldest country in the world. That disadvantage you have a window. You have an opportunity that India is a very fast growing country. We have leadership that is taking India places. But there is a reason for you to celebrate, and there is an effort to be put in at this point of time if time is good for you. So thanking Mr. Shashi Chaudhary for taking out his valuable time and speaking to our students, parents, teachers, everyone. And thanks to Roongta Group and the Institution Innovation Council of the Ministry of Education now for giving us this platform to interact. Thank you very much, sir.
Thank you. Wonderful, everybody. Thank you, Saurabh. Thank you.
Thank you, sir. Thank you very much, sir.